Our final is set. It's going to be Serena against Halep. Serena Williams with a chance to make history.
Yeah, and her biggest challenge is going to be, let's forget about that and get back to business.
She has said openly and often that that Margaret Court record is something that is motivating her. So it means something to her.
We arrive at the championship match with two of the biggest stars in the sport. Simona Halep seeking her second Grand Slam title. Serena Williams on the doorstep of history with her 24th major title now within her grasp.
Serena is obviously going after Margaret Court's record. I wonder how desperate you are to make her wait a bit longer for that.
I'm desperate to win Wimbledon more than desperate to stop her. So I will focus on myself. I'm not thinking about her record.
It's really not about 24 or 23 or 25. It's really just about going out there and giving my best effort.
Big match for Serena, Mary, trying to get to magic number 24.
Another miss.
And it's Serena who started just a little nervy. Who tucks away the opening set in under half an hour. She's gonna get louder.
This is where you've got to hang with Serena when you're the opponent, and she's getting louder. Gotta stand up to that challenge.
Nobody puts Simona in a corner. Halep continues to shine on center court. She knows how good Halep can be. Oh. Championship point for Simona Halep. Could anyone have dreamed that Simona Halep would win her second major against one of the all-time greats? That was absolutely stunning.
And the ladies singles champion for 2019, Simona Halep. Have you ever played a better match than that?
Never. It was the best match, and it's something very special, and I will never forget this day. Thank you very much.
She said she's never played a better match, and Serena said there was not much I could do. Mary, 56 minutes of work. What did you see out there?
Halep played the match of her life, and it was very good to watch her do that. But we heard Serena going into the final match. She said, you know, in the other major finals, she said, this time I'm going to be more calm. But again, I go back to a word I used at the beginning of the day. She was too subdued. I think she can't quite find, it was the wrong energy level for Serena, and props to Halep, but I'm sure Serena walked off that court realizing that she just didn't bring the right energy, the right emotion.
Yeah, it was about, 18 minutes in, she's love four down. And yeah. She didn't start well, and we're not used to seeing that. Normally, even if Serena's not the quickest starter, she can hold serve to kind of hang tight in the first set until she starts to fire on all cylinders. You had Halep, who sometimes looks burdened by the pressure also, looks so free out there. And because she was able to get off to such a good start, I think that really calmed her nerves down in the beginning. And that let Halep get a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more free with her shots. And then for Serena, now here we go. Here's another Grand Slam final where she's expected to win. She wants to win. And she gets off to this slow start. Remember, she had lost the Wimbledon final the year before. She had lost the US Open final before in straight sets. And it had a sense of, oh gosh, here we go again. And I just felt like she couldn't get out of that pattern at all.
Yeah. And Lindsay, you know, it was Simona Halep who served so well on this day. She served in the low 80s. Serena couldn't get out of the high 50s for the day. And so obviously that is a huge part of her weaponry that just wasn't there for her.
You look at something, where could Serena attack, right? What's the weak part of Halep's game? And you go, probably her serve. Serena had one break point and didn't convert it. So Halep did a nice job defending her serve there.
And Serena, not only arguably the greatest server of all time, but one of the best returners as well. Lindsay, there's a 10-year age gap between Halep and Williams. How much was that a factor, and will that be a factor going forward for Serena?
It's hard to say because we think of Serena as superwoman. That it's hard to put that age by her or that she had a maternity break because we think she's capable of overcoming anything. And we're not sure, right? Is it the physicality of it, or is it the pressure that she puts on herself to get to this Margaret Court record? I don't know. I look at it that she has the record, the open air before then. I don't know. She's won so many. I don't love to compare those anyways, but it seems like everybody else has put this on her. So it's hard to know exactly which is it. Is it the pressure, or could it be the age? I don't know. She's one of the greatest athletes we've ever seen.
That's always the question, isn't it, Liz? Because Serena's been through so much. She's had all kinds of injuries. She's had some heartaches. Now she's a mom. I mean, how much we know what we put on her. The question, I think, going forward is how much is Serena Williams going to want to put on herself? We don't know.
Well, as long as she keeps making those finals, she'll have the opportunities. Halep, lifetime 2-9 against Serena, but in those two wins, she's never dropped more than two games in a set. Pretty dominating performance from Halep to take the ladies' title at Wimbledon. And she would become the first Romanian to lift that trophy as well. When we come back, an epic gentlemen's final.